with the management plan here is to thin out understory trees that would normally be found in wetter river habitats that invade these upland areas when there is a lack of fire. Typically, we remove the trees that are about 10 inches in diameter or less. We treat the stumps so that they do not resprout. We will move through an area until we've achieved a tree density, which is the number of trees per acre, that is acceptable for an upland forest, which helps us to push our prescribed burns through and make those burns more effective. That starts the process of habitat restoration, when the species that would grow in these types of habitats will start to reappear in more robust numbers and get to the point where those trees, where those plants, where those shrubs can all set seed and revegetate the forest to really get us back to the woodlands that were here 100 years ago. It makes resources available to the native plants that grow here. There are over 100 wildflowers here that you can enjoy. The native shrubs that both birds and insects depend on. By pushing back the exotic invasive shrubs like honeysuckle and buckthorn, making room for things like hazelnut, witch hazel, pagoda dogwood, and blackhaw, all of those species have both the habitat structure and the food resources that are necessary for them to complete their life cycles and flourish, so that people who come here in the future will still be able to enjoy those species. Managed to get a fire in on the last good day to burn. The pine seedlings generally germinate in the summer or the fall, so they had an entire summer of open. It was warm, it was humid, good conditions for germination apparently. Garlic mustard is the prevalent invasive species at White Pines Forest and throughout the woodlands of Illinois. It is also the enemy of all woodland species and all biologists in the state. It is a prolific seed producer and releases chemicals into the soil that suppresses native vegetation, allowing the garlic mustard to take over the woods. The management that we use in the woods allows us to keep the garlic mustard in check, and it allows native vegetation to thrive once again. Garlic mustard is also edible. You can find recipes for it on the state of Illinois' DNR website. If you don't want to cook it, you can always just eat it fresh. Spicy. That one's got a kick to it.